Belgravia Police Station. It's 20th of January 2009, and we're about to go into the police station to report war crimes, crimes against humanity, genocide and other offences by our government, members of our government, against the Iraqi people. Most people don't know that the world has a number of universal war laws which have been agreed over the past 80 years, but which the British, American and Israeli governments are ignoring.
In 1928, the world, as a result of the horrors of the First World War, signed a pact, a treaty, agreeing never to wage a war of aggression and to settle all international disputes peacefully, whatever their nature. One of the first nations to sign it was Britain, and also America, Germany, Japan, Italy, France, and many other major nations. Now, this was broken for the first time in the Second World War. And at the Nuremberg War Crimes trials, Germany's leaders were tried, convicted, and punished for 11 breaches of the International Treaty for the Renunciation of War, which is known as the Kellogg-Briand Pact.
What kind of action do the police normally give you, Chris?
It varies from just getting thrown out, they say it's this is a stunt and nothing to do with them, to one or two people who have said, OK, we'll take it further, and they've started to take it further, but they tend to always get cut off by the senior corrupt police officials.
When Bush and Blair invaded Iraq, they breached the Kellogg-Briand Pact.
They invaded and occupied a free nation state. That's the same crime committed by Germany's leaders in 1946. And yet no one has done anything about it.
Because this is a central police station with responsibility for where the crimes have been committed, then they should be aware of the fact that they have that responsibility to follow up crime reports. So I think it should be reasonably straightforward, but we'll see.
Britain's most recent war law is the International Criminal Court Act of 2001. It was passed on September the 1st, 2001. And it prohibits genocide, crimes against humanity, war crimes, and conduct ancillary to such crimes.
People ask me, well, is an attack on Iraq genocide? Yes, it is definitely a crime of genocide as it is defined in the International Criminal Court Act. So genocide is when one kills a person or persons because of their nationality, race, religion, or ethnicity as part of a state policy.
Basically, I'm in here to report a number of crimes associated with the Iraq War. What I have done here is to lay out criminal offences by at least 2,000 British citizens related to the wars with Iraq and the crimes of murder, conspiracy to murder, incitement to murder, genocide, crimes against humanity, war crimes and conduct ancillary to such crimes under English law, and also a crime against peace and complicity in a crime against peace under the Nuremberg principles, as well as crimes under the Rome Statute of the International Criminal Court.
It's quite important to realise that the person who orders an attack to take place is the key player, is the war criminal, if you like.
And in this case, it was Tony Blair and members of the cabinet. They are personally responsible for every death that has taken place in Iraq since we invaded Iraq on March the 19th, 2003.
Okay. Are you a witness to all this?
A witness?
Yeah.
Yes, I have witnessed for the last 6 years the preparations made by our government to kill Iraqi children. And I'm concerned.
So you're not actually a witness to the offences?
Yes, I have seen these offences, the offences of preparing and conspiring to murder, and I want to make sure that something starts, because I have been trying to do this for six years, and I find that there is corruption at senior levels that is stopping criminal investigations once they start.
So broadly then, we have a whole range, the world has a whole range of laws saying we will never wage war with another nation. And our governments are deliberately keeping us in ignorance of those laws. The police are paid to enforce the law, and they have a duty to investigate these crimes and arrest the offenders.
You can't report a crime of murder if you've not witnessed it.
If I come across a dead body or I come across conspiracy to murder, it is my job to report that to the police. Well, I have been informed.
Have you been to Iraq?
No.
Have you seen it on the TV?
What?
What all this genocide and murder you're on about?
You have seen it just as much as I have, haven't you?
I'm an ex-soldier. I've seen a lot more than what you've seen firsthand.
Fine. But have you reported it then?
I was a serving soldier.
Yeah, I can understand that. Have you reported the crimes that are taking place?
So, under the laws of conflict, the crimes are different.
No, they're not.
So, in terms of genocide, what we have to do is to prove in court that Tony Blair and George Bush and all the rest of them planned to kill innocent Iraqi civilians. Now, in order to prove that, we can go back to some of the statements they made. And the statement that Tony Blair made.
He'd been waging the war for 4 years, and he was talking to a group of about 60 or 70 officers and men up there. And they were complaining to him about the deaths, injuries, and the effect on the civilians, the killing of civilians, and so on. Now, he didn't know what to say to this, as reported by Martin Amis in the Guardian, I believe it was. So what he said was, so we're killing more of them than they kill us. You're getting back out there after them. It's brilliant, actually.
Now, for him to say that 4 years after he'd started the attack, to my mind, proves his intent to kill.
Now, my understanding is that the police have a duty to take account of a crime report in order to pass it on to those people in the Metropolitan Police with the expertise to deal with this.
What, you have that? You want that open?
Right, can you turn that off and leave the police station, please, mate? Turn it off and leave the police station.
In fact, sir, we'll have that problem, sir. You're filming in the police station.
We're not making it out. Police station. Turn it off.
It is. Well, I don't care. We're not having it on. It's a police station. You have to respect other people's confidentiality here.
There we are. Here's a complaints form for you, but I'm not going to document any complaints.
And also, that one as well in your pocket as well, sir. Tell us what happened when the police came in.
They really virtually tried to throw us out of the station, and at which point you, Dean, went back in successfully to reclaim your camera, which they had confiscated, and obviously had an effect on the desk sergeant, a beneficial effect. So what happened when I went in, finally, he said, well, can we start this over again? We now have a crime report number, which they have produced. And so we will be following up this to ensure that the police do what they are paid to do and enforce the law.